Computer Tutorial Series of the Mobile Computing and Wireless Communication. I am your instructor, Varshata, from ITSET Department. Let's start our lecture. Okay, so topics to be covered in this lecture, Bluetooth Protocol Stack. Okay, from last two lectures, continuously we are seeing the topic related to the Bluetooth. Now let's start Bluetooth Protocol Stack, and this is the most standard questions. Bluetooth protocol stack. Okay, so Bluetooth use the spread spectrum technology. As I already told you in last lectures, that Bluetooth uses spread spectrum technology at the physical layer while using the both direct sequence and frequency hopping spread spectrum technology. Okay, all of you aware about this, that DSSS, that is direct sequence spread spectrum and frequency hopping spread spectrum. Next, it used the connection list, that is ACL, asynchronous connection link, connection list link, then connection oriented, that is SCO, synchronous connection oriented links. Okay, so this Bluetooth protocol used this two type of different link. Now let's see. Okay, so this is Bluetooth protocol stack. Bluetooth protocol stack can be divided into four categories. Okay, four basic layers according to their functions. So which are these four categories? Let's see. First, Bluetooth is divided in the Bluetooth core protocols. Okay, so which are these Bluetooth core protocols? That is baseband, link manager protocol, service discovery protocol, and logical link control and adaptation protocol, that is also known as L2CAP. Now, next category is what? Cable replacement protocol. Next layer is a cable replacement protocol, in which there is a RF communication, radio frequency communication is there. Then next, telephonic control protocol, in which we have the telephonic control specification binary, that is known as 3CSP. And next is AT command, that is attention command. Okay, then last category is what? Adopted protocols, in which we have the point-to-point protocol, TCP/IP, OPEX protocol, and next is a content format. Okay, now let's have a look at this. So let's start a Bluetooth protocol stack. Okay, so Bluetooth protocol stack. Here, this is our Bluetooth protocol stack. Okay, so in exam, you have to draw the figure like this. Now let's have a look at it one by one. First of all, Bluetooth core protocol, as we have this first layer. So which protocol will work as a Bluetooth core protocol? So first is baseband. Okay, so baseband enables the physical radio frequency link for the Bluetooth to communicate. Okay, so work of the baseband is what? Enables the physical radio frequency link. Now, next, link manager protocol. So what is the work of the link manager protocol? Let's see. So link manager protocol, it manages the devices in a range, power modes, connections, duty cycles, etc. So this maintenance of this function will be done by the link manager protocol. Now next is the L2CAP. L2CAP is what? Logical link control and adaptation protocol. It is responsible for segmentation and reassembly of the fragmented packets with their multiplexing. Okay, so using the Bluetooth device, if we are transmitting the data, then data will not transmit at the same time at once. They will transmit by byte by byte. Okay, so all entire data is divided in the different parts, so that is the segmentation. At the receiver side, it will be recovered, so that is what? Reassembly. So this functionality will be done by the L2CAP. Next is what? STP. STP is what? Service Discovery Protocol. It enables a device to join a PicoNet. Okay, so when any device want to join in a PicoNet, this STP will be used to join in that PicoNet or in that scanner. Now, next layer is what? Cable Replacement Protocol. So, in cable replacement protocol, we have the RFCOM, that is a radio frequency communication. It emulates the RS-232 control and data signal over the Bluetooth baseband protocol. Okay, so it provides a type of communication. Next is a telephony control protocol. So, telephony control protocol, that is what? A TCSP. So, telephony control specification binary. What it defines? It defines the call control signaling protocol, and it handles the mobility management for the group of the Bluetooth TCS devices. Okay, so it's provide the control signaling protocol. Call control management is provided by the TCS protocol. Now next is attention command. So it defines a set of commands by which a mobile phone can be used and controlled as a modem or fax and data transfers. Okay, so that is what attention command. When using the Bluetooth devices, because all the devices are connected, so to provide the commands to that particular device, attention command is used. Next is adopted protocol. So point-to-point protocol is adopted protocol. It means taking the IP packets to or from the point-to-point layer. So, and it's placing them onto the LAN. So that point-to-point protocol is used. Then next, transmission control protocol. All of you aware about this protocol. Okay, it is used for communication across the internet. Then next, object exchange protocol. It is a session protocol. It is used to exchange the object and used to browse the content of the folders on the remote devices. Okay, so it provides the session and it is used to transfer the data. The next is a content format. So content format used to exchange the messages and the notes and synchronize the data among the various devices. Now let's have a look at some protocol in detail. So first of all, the link manager protocol. The link manager protocol manages the various aspects of the radio link between a master and a slave, and the current parameter setting of the devices. So these all are the functions. These are the done by the link manager protocol. So which are the functionality? It supports the authentication, pairing, and encryption. So that we have seen in the last lecture when how Bluetooth device discovered. So at that time, authentication, pairing, and encryption will be done by the link manager protocol. Then next, synchronization. Synchronization, that means you have the ultimate synchronization using the Bluetooth device. As you receive the call, you have notification on your wristband. Okay, if you are accepting that call and you are talking to your friends, you are hearing the same voice. At the same time, the data will be transferred to your particular device. Okay, so if you have the Bluetooth headphone, you can receive this data at the same synchronicity as they are going to receive in your mobile phone. Then capability negotiation, then quality of the service negotiation, power control, okay, then link supervision and state and transmission mode change. Okay, park mode, standby mode. Okay, so this all are the state and transmission mode change. Okay, master or slave. Like this way. So these all are the functionality will be performed by the link manager protocol. Now, to save the battery, power, as we have seen in last slide, save the power. Okay, so to save the battery power, Bluetooth device can go into one of the three power states, which are first is a sleep state. Sleep state, that means what? The sleep state has a highest power consumption of the low power states. Okay, then next is what? Hold state. The device does not release its AMA, that means active member address. Okay, but stops ACL transmission. ACL, that means asynchronous connectionless transmission. Okay, so it will stop this transmission. A slave may still exchange SCO packets, that is synchronous connection oriented packet. So using this, SCO slave still is able to communicate. If there is no activity in PicoNet, the slave may either reduce the power consumption or it can participate in another PicoNet. So this is the work that is done in the hold state. Now next is a park state. So in this state, the device has the lowest duty cycle and the lowest power consumption. Okay, so the device releases its AMA, that is active member address, and receives a parked member address, because now device is in park mode. After some time, when the device will become activated, at that time it will recover its AMA, that is active member address. The device is still a member of the PicoNet, but given a room for another device to become the active. Now, if any device want to be activated, it is in park mode. So any slave device should have to become a park mode, should have to be in a park mode, so any other device can be activated. So likewise, it gives the room to any other device. Okay. Now next is logical link control and adaptation protocol. Okay. It is a data link control protocol on a top of the baseband layer offering the logical channels between Bluetooth device with the quality of service properties. Okay. So what is the work of it? It works on the top baseband layer, offer the logical channels. There are three types of logical channel that is offered by the L2CAP that we will see later. L2CAP is available for ACL only. ACL that is asynchronous connection, place link only. Now, L2CAP provides three different types of logical channel that are transported via ACL between master and slave. Okay, which are those three types of logical channel? Let's learn. So, these are the three types of channel: connectionless, connection oriented, and signaling. Okay, so connectionless, thus unidirectional channels are typically used to broadcast from a master to slave. So when master want to broadcast, at that time this channel will be used. Next is a connection oriented channel. So this connection oriented channel, each channel of this type is a bidirectional. Bidirectional, that means both the side. Okay, and supports the quality of service flow specification for each direction, whether it is a master to slave and slave to master. Then last channel is what? Signaling channel. This third type of logical channel is used to exchanging the signaling message between L2CAP entities. Okay, so it is used to exchange the signaling message. Each channel can be identified by its channel identifier. Each and every channel has its own identifier. Okay, so these three channels will be used by the logical link control and adaptation protocol. Now next is the service discovery protocol. So what is the use of the service discovery protocol? As name suggests, it discovered the Bluetooth device. Okay, so Bluetooth device should work together with other device in unknown environment in an ad hoc network. Okay, so it is essential to know what devices, or more specifically what services, are available in a radio proximity. So the services that is available in that particular radio proximity area, that is defined by the STP. To find the new device, to find the new services, Bluetooth defines the service discovery protocols. So STP defines only the discovery of the services, not their users. How to use, how to transfer the data, that will not be specified by the STP. Just it discovered the device only. Okay, device that want to offer a service have to install on a STP server. Okay, so whatever the device want to provide this STP service, that should be installed on a STP server. For all other device on STP client is sufficient. So summary of this lecture, we have learned about the Bluetooth protocol stack. Okay, so we have learned there are four layers for the Bluetooth protocol stack, and we have learned the functionality of each and every protocol in Bluetooth protocol stack. So today we are ending this unit. From the next lecture, we will start a new unit, that is Android. Okay, so we will meet in the next lecture with a new topic. Thank you for watching. We will meet in the next lecture. Thank you.